How strange to think what could have been, but for the subtle shift of an ever-changing wind as it begins to blow. Have we any control, or as it throws right to left, is it better just to let it? I wonder now, more than ever before, at how weightless I was when it swept me from the floor. And impressions are left of those delicate events, but they shatter in my mind as I try to recollect, between the greens and the reds, what was said and what was meant. All clarity is lost, only gain, only cost. And I wonder now, more than ever before, at how easily we break, at how easily we fall. To disrepair, disrepair, we turn around, descend the stairs, and step out of the door, back to the lives we knew before. And just as lovers do, we just hide behind the truth, as if it really justifies the cruelty of the crime. It makes me wonder now, more than ever before, if the man that I've grown to be is really gentle at all. And is it good or is it bad, the shadow that I cast on the road I choose to walk, and the drawl I choose to talk? Is it for God or for man that I should play my hand? Is there meaning in the lock, or just some bloody game of cards? I wonder now, more than ever before, how such things can be known before the closing of the door. Into my chamber I withdraw to watch these evenings fall. I've grown peculiar in my ways, more solitary by the day, but it was right at the time, and those decisions, they were mine. But now the ships are getting in, and my hair is growing thin. And I wonder now, more than ever before, if perhaps it might be time that we call the thing a draw. But having known, having seen, having reason to believe, and having held to my chest what I would hope to hold again, what good would it do? To call a truce would be to lose, to throw stones at the clock, thinking the time would maybe stop. And I wonder now, more than ever before, as I gaze upon a picture that I've hung upon my wall. It shows my brother and me, age 7 and 3. And in the reflection in the glass, I see my father looking back. And I wonder now, more than ever before, where the time really goes, the abstraction of it all. Yes, I wonder now, as the wind begins to howl, if perhaps it might be best if I just wandered a little less.